My name is Jennifer Gooch. We're in Lexington, Kentucky at the University of Kentucky. I'm in Donna Wilcock's lab. I'm a first year grad student who's currently working on inflammatory phenotypes in Alzheimer's disease. I grew up in science. My dad was a medical physicist. I learned how to drive via physics. My brother and my sister, they're also in the science field. They're older than me. My brother is getting his PhD in inorganic chemistry, and my sister is a doctor. So I've always been around the science field, and my parents have always encouraged it. From a young age, I like doing puzzles, and I felt like the brain is the black box, and you just always want to figure it out. So ever since I was little, I just remember always being into science. I was always interested in psychology and neuroscience. When I was 11, my grandmother was diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease, so I got to see that progression, and that just really interested me into the mechanisms of Alzheimer's. So that's how I started with Alzheimer's disease specifically. I just hope to create new knowledge for further treatments and preventions of the disease, because Alzheimer's is a growing illness, and it really affects families. And if we add years onto people's lives, that will greatly benefit their quality of life. So in lab, I collaborate with a lot of different researchers in the Sanders Brown Center. I'm a first year PhD student, so I did lots of rotations. I rotated with four different PIs in Sanders Brown, so I got experience to see what they do and bring it into this lab. I often go out with the lab mates because we form bonds inside the lab and outside of the lab. It just makes it more fun and more enjoyable to work in this environment. To process my results, I often use microtomes, dissection brains. We use immunohistochemistry. I would use the microscope to look at the staining protocols. The goals of Sanders Brown Center of Aging are primarily to find preventions and treatments for Alzheimer's disease and vascular dementia. It's a growing illness in America, and we're looking to increase the quality of life in individuals so their families and they can enjoy life more. I would say just get into a lab as soon as possible. Try it out a couple hours a week. Even if it's just washing dishes, you're still in the lab environment and you can see what's going on. I personally started working in a lab when I was a freshman in college, and I was washing dishes, and I start getting interested in the grad students' projects, and they start letting me do more and more research. And by the time I was a senior, I got my own projects to work on and my own funding. So it starts small and work out from there.